This is the solution to written homework 88. Okay, so we're given a bunch of options, and we're supposed to choose the one with the most money. So choose the option with the most money. That is to say, the highest payout. Okay, so option one. So they all have P is 2,000, T is 10 years, they all have that, and then option one specifically has that the rate 0.0712. And that N is 12. So the model that we're using is A is P multiplied by 1 plus R over N to NT. So we'll just plug all of these values in to get the account balance for option one. So that'd be 2,000 multiplied by 1 plus 0.0712 over 12 multiplied by 12 times 10. Two thousand times 1 plus 0.0712 divided by 12 with an exponent 12 times 10. Okay, so then that number is 4067.56. Okay, option two. Again, P is 2,000. T is 10. And now the rate is just a little higher. 713. But N is every 2 months, so that means that N is 6, because there's 12 months in a year, so if we're doing it every 2 months, there's 6 compoundings. So A is 2,000 multiplied by 1 plus 0.0713 over 6 raised to exponent 6 times 10. Okay, so this is 4063.09. Option three, P is 2,000, T is 10, R is a little bigger, 0.0714, and it compounds quarterly, so that means that there's 4 compoundings. So in this case, the account balance formula is 2,000 multiplied by 1 plus 0.0714 divided by 4 raised to exponent 4 times 10. It's 4058.65. So, as it turns out, the lowest interest rate turned out to have the best payout because the compoundings happened to be high enough, and that difference was big enough, so that even though this one has the lowest interest rate, it has the highest payout. So best is option